Hey guys, welcome to Game Soup. Today we're playing Basket Belle, a game by Bean. I'm Ed.
This is Joe.
I'm on the mouse here. Yes, I said mouse. We're playing a mouse game. And, oh wait, no, we're not playing a mouse game. We're playing a keyboard game, right?
Yeah.
So the controls are left, right, and X, as far as I know. That's as far as we've gotten, testing the game. Other than that, I have no idea what's going on here. So tell me about how you found this game, Joe.
It was on sale on Steam.
It was on the Steam.
And it looked really interesting.
Yeah.
I feel like I like basketball. I like video games.
You don't like basketball. Yeah. You don't love basketball. You're a gamer.
Yeah, all I have is my entire collection of games at home, besides the games we play on Game Super, is NCAA, NBA, 2K.
Oh, no. That's not true at all.
Yeah, my favorite game of all time is NBA, 2K, 2K2.
2K2, yeah. I really think the series went downhill after 2K2, starting with 2K3. You need to fly, you will. This looks like an artsy game.
But right now, this is the tutorial. So Dad's teaching us how to play the game.
Now shoot. Hold X, release at peak. Like that. All right, so we're playing some basketball, some b-ball with my bros. Well,
that was a really good shot.
Hey, thanks, man. It was really challenging.
All right. So now we're playing basketball against this little...
Move.
There you go, slide.
Yeah.
So you gotta slide under this guy.
You gotta fake him out. Slam.
Can you slam dunk?
You can. I did it earlier while you were looking out the window.
Thanks for embarrassing me.
That's all right. I mean, I embarrass you on the court too with my b-ball skills, right? So, how's this any different? I'm just kidding. Two in a row.
So I want you to meet the newest member of our family, Belle. So that's his little sister, I guess. This main character's little sister.
Yeah. Her full name is
Belle. She grew up fast.
She stood up and was already like 4 feet tall. When you're older, it'll come in handy. For you, son. Making you my b-ball.
This ball got me where I am today. Now it's yours.
Oh.
Heads up.
All right. If you insist. 5.
So we have 5 points, and somehow this blob thing is 1 point.
Yeah, what is this blob anyway? Slam, dizunk. There you go. Yeah, why are we fighting a blob? This amorphous... Furthermore, you just use the same tactic every time?
I think so, yeah. It's a little repetitive.
Is there a point... Yeah.
I think it's probably just going to tell us another part of the story.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay.
So there's Belle.
All right, Belle. Score's tied. 2 seconds left on the clock. Shoot the basketball. Basket Belle. Emoticon. Basket Belle. Emoticon.
She shoots it like a little kid.
Aw.
Underhand.
I think she is a little kid.
Oh, yeah.
I'll go get it. Okay, emoticon. Oh.
So now we're in the forest.
Now it's an adventure game.
I thought that was like a garage over there. Usually the...
Garage?
The thing's up against... Usually the basketball hoop's like against the garage at someone's house.
But, yeah, you're
or
right.
Or they're at the court, but...
Okay, so now X just jumps. Now it's just a straight-up platformer. All right.
But this basketball court seems to be in the middle of
a woody forest.
Yeah.
Middle of a wooded meadow, grassy knoll. All right, so now it's a platformer. It's not a particularly incompetent or competent platformer. Seems fine for now,
it seems,
I guess.
Passable, right? I like that the ball is the bass.
Yeah, that is really
good. Like the bass drum.
Yeah.
And it bounces in beat to the drum.
It's yeah, we'll have to show that. Yeah, whenever you stand still, it it's dribbled in time with the music. I just said dribbled in time to the music.
And that bass drum doesn't kick in unless you have the ball in your hand.
That's really cool. Uh-oh. Now he's got the...
Okay, so it does break it up a little bit. The first two were the same type of thing. You just gotta shoot it in. I think you just gotta get it in there.
Yeah. I just wanna listen
to
the music.
He's just guarding you. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's really cool.
I guess that blob can't steal from you.
I guess. I can just run freely, huh?
Well, now he's in the way.
Oh, no.
He went on the other side. Now you're going to do the old
fake out. It worked all the other times. 9. All right.
I think you got to get 11 to win, so you're about to win.
That's what the rules said. But it's just like... Well, I didn't do this 11 times. We did this, what, like 5 times maybe? This is the end of the game. Game over. Thanks for playing, right?
Yeah.
This game has got a really cool graphic style, though.
Yeah, it's pretty unique.
It looks like paper cutouts, kind of. It's really smooth. Like, kind of slick looking. I like it.
Yeah, I thought this would be a cool game for GS.
Yeah.
We like to play weird, kind of weird different games on here sometimes.
Oh. Oh.
Turned out I had a mouth.
Like a giant worm? Oh.
He's guarding the basketball with his life.
It's not worth it. Oh.
So now we're in the belly of the beast.
We sure are.
Like Gears of War 2. This happened in Gears of War 2.
Oh.
Oh boy, that would have been a crusher.
I feel like you can't die in this game. I'm just gonna jump backwards.
Oh, that thing's the ball.
It is?
Or it's something like a ball.
Oh, why? Why is this happening?
Does it shoot another one out? Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of surreal. I like that song. I like the songs, though.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
The songs are all pretty, like... Yeah, they're kind of basic kind of beats.
I want to hear from the dev about this game.
But when you have the ball, that's where it really you really start to feel it.
You know what
that reminds you don't feel the music without that kick drum.
Yeah, it's all about that bass. No, you know what this reminds me of is when you get on Yoshi in Mario World, right?
Yeah.
And the music picks up some additional percussive sections. Why is it doing that?
I think you gotta jump on that green one there. Oh, you shot. What the hell? Can you platform jump anymore?
You cannot. Am I just stuck here now?
I think so, yeah. You probably just gotta shoot from here. Maybe it's just timing?
I guess.
You can't see what you're doing.
Yeah, how are you supposed to know? What? Am I missing something?
I don't think so. It's a really hard shot. Maybe you gotta do it from farther back?
Maybe.
To get a different angle at it?
Well, what happens if we just leave these? Just shoot it from right here.
No, maybe farther back? Does it matter? I guess maybe the timing? Maybe you have to do it right at the top of the jump?
Like that. It looks like that one doesn't move, though.
Yeah, that one doesn't seem to move. Maybe it lowers, though, because see how they all lower? It's showing you that they all lower. If the first one's lowered, they'll all be lowered, so you probably want it to be lowered, so you probably want to shoot it from on top of this one.
All right.
So you definitely can't get on top of the next one, right?
I don't know. I mean...
I don't think you can.
We have three mechanics. We have sliding, jumping, which we can't do anymore.
All right, yeah, I guess just try shooting it from here again. That wasn't it.
Wait, let's see here. I wonder if this is a switch, like a permanent...
Oh, yeah, maybe you can... That goes up slowly. You just gotta do it fast. Okay, so sort of a little puzzle thing there for you.
All right, so we just gotta go real fast. Is that fast enough?
I think that was fast enough.
Yes!
Okay, cool.
Two.
That wasn't too bad.
Three. Nah, it wasn't so bad.
Sometimes puzzles like that can be really annoying if they're too obtuse, but...
Yeah.
Is that the right word, obtuse?
Yeah. Yeah. Or like...
Esoteric?
Yeah. Yeah, like if it just required you to be pixel perfect, you know, that would be really frustrating.
Yeah.
But that didn't at all. Oh. 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 All right.
Okay, well... I think you can get back up there.
Yeah. They must regenerate, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Whoops.
Looks like they do. So we're in the belly of the beast.
I guess we are. What beast, though? The worm beast? The basketball worm?
Yeah.
It's the controls are, I mean, a little clunky.
Uh-oh. It looks that way.
Yeah. I mean, it is mouse and... Not mouse and keyboard. It's just keyboard. Maybe we should have joy-to-keyed this. You were probably right about that, but... Wait, what?
Oh, no.
It looked like there was a ground there, you know?
Yeah, there's no controller support for this game, from what we saw.
Yeah, it's really cumbersome playing certain games with a keyboard. I look like an idiot, but the controls are a little clunky.
It looks that way.
Yeah,
I mean... I think the controls look clunky.
I mean, you can tell just based on the character physics, it looks a little clunky.
Okay, so that's a slam dunk right
there. Yeah. Alright. Alright then. Well, that wasn't too bad. Okay. What? Alright.
So you gotta go all the way back up just to try it again? So you gotta do this and then go, and then rush back. So you had to be here anyway. Yeah,
looks like it's the same as that last puzzle.
Yeah. It just looks like a little bit harder. Yeah. So, some game design principles in effect here. You do an easier version of a similar type of puzzle, and then you give them the harder.
Yeah.
You show them really what you wanted to do.
Oh, God. Yeah, it looks like you do have to be pretty fast on this one. So, jump.
Yeah.
Jump.
Hopefully, it doesn't get any harder than this, because this looks. Looks pretty brutal.
Well, come on. I think you want to run off the ledge there just to... Oof. You son of a bee.
It really is...
God. Yeah, the jumping is not... You know, for a game that only has two controls, the jumping is not as smooth as it should be. All right, come on. And shoot.
That's if this doesn't work, that was about as perfect. Oof. Jesus.
Yeah, that was close.
They really
though.
Wanted that was like pixel perfect, and that was still close.
Yeah.
So that might have been a little bit too difficult.
So long,
for this type, for like this type of game.
Oh, that's not as bad as you think. What if you fall? Aw. This is a character story about Belle.
An all-star dunk.
So is this?
So he's bonding with his little sister.
Yeah, it's kind of cute. Look how he runs, though. He runs like a... I don't know, he runs like he's got something wrong with his legs. Oh!
Just gotta get on top of there. Yeah, so this kind of game... I kind of hope it's not too difficult, because this seems like the kind of game that you want to experience and, like, tell the story. You want to see the story told, and you want to experience the look of it and the story.
Yeah, this is a game...
And the music.
Jesus. This is a game that's about story and presentation more than anything, I think.
Yeah. It's... I hope it doesn't get too difficult, because this is the type of game that...
Slam dunk.
You don't want to be too difficult.
Nah.
So you have to get 11 points, I think, to win.
All right. Just moonwalk a little bit here. I wonder if the whole game's going to be like this. Just puzzles. Because that was not what I was expecting.
No, not at all. Oops.
Wait.
You didn't get crushed.
Don't get crushed. Oh, but you have to do it fast.
What the hell? You have to do it... Oh, okay.
Really fast, yeah. Well, sort of fast. Wait.
Is that where you get the ball?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so you probably got to travel across here.
Yeah.
There you go.
I'm smart. Really strange color choices here, too. Like, the basketball is bright green. Everything else is purple. Purple and green.
Yeah, purple and green is an odd color combination.
They're not complementary, right?
No.
They're just... I mean, it looks fine.
You can do it. There's no rules against it. And it doesn't look terrible because it's still only a two-color combination. So pretty much any two colors that you put together is not going to be terrible.
Except for, like, I don't know, brown and orange. I'm not a fan of that. Come on.
Well, yeah, brown is...
Brown and orange just looks muddy to me. Oh, hey! But then again, that's like...
Brown's kind of all the colors mixed together, though.
Yeah, I guess that's why it looks muddy. Wait.
Or a bunch of colors mixed together, mostly like orange and yellow, but...
Oh! Okay. Wait. Huh? Oh, it's a jump. Gimme! Cool. Slam dunk! Every level is a slam dunk!
This game is a slam dunk.
This game is a slam dunk.
It's pretty cool.
It is pretty cool. I've never played a game like this before.
Yeah, Ed's playing. I played VVVV.
What is this?
So Ed's playing basketball.
Yeah, you know. Just like in real life, my interests include basketball. What's with that noise? Oh. Gimme, gimme, gimme!
You gotta catch it. It's not just gonna sit there on the floor. I see.
Wait. What? I think I screwed it up. I think I have to shoot the ball. I could see this getting pretty hard, too. Okay, so I can't fall down there is what the deal is. So we gotta open this up. I'm gonna open this up. I'm gonna get this ball. Come here. Yeah.
Oh, almost didn't make it.
Alright, so now, okay, so there's a platform down there, so we're gonna... Yeah.
Okay.
Slam dunk.
You got it.
That wasn't so hard.
So it's sort of a puzzle platformer.
Yeah. Not too bad, though. Not too bad at all. Well, I will say the full screen options, the size options are kind of lacking. We're playing this game in a very small window. I think it's like, hey, it's 810 by 409. We're playing in this really, really weird small size. And it's either this or full screen. So you don't really get a lot in the way of options. But, you know, I guess for a small title like this, it's not the end of the world.
Yeah, I don't think it's a real expensive game. It's not a real high price tag. I don't remember how much I paid for it, but it was on sale.
Wait, what? I can't push this. Can I like climb up there? I don't think so.
Oh, I see. So you gotta shoot that probably a couple times.
Yeah.
Do it three times.
I missed.
Take a shot.
I missed that giant. I'm just like tapping X, and I guess I just have to be closer to it.
Yeah.
There we go. I just wanted to have
maybe do one more.
Yeah.
There you go. You got it. You got it. Oh man.
Yeah.
Getting greedy here.
I'm so slick. So slick. Wait.
Can you? No. If you jump, you'll shoot, won't you?
Yeah. Hey. Whoop. Oh.
Oh, you have to bring that down, come back over here, and then shoot it real quick while that is down from blocking you.
Yeah.
Stopping you from, yeah.
All right. That's cool. I wish you weren't forced to shoot, but I guess I understand it. Let's try it again. At least these levels are really tiny. It doesn't seem like you're going to be stuck for a very long time, but what do I know?
Yeah, I hope there's nothing that's really difficult. In this game, this is definitely a game you do not want to have any extreme amount of difficulty in.
Why? What did I do wrong? Except that whenever you mess up, you have to do the entire level again. Which, I don't know. It's not my favorite thing.
Yeah, it's that it's short enough. Each section is short enough.
All right, that should be enough. Slide down here, and no.
Did you not hold the slide down long enough?
Not long enough, yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
It looks pretty clunky.
No! Where do I shoot it from? Here?
I think you're supposed to get on top of this platform, but you can't, though.
You can't, yeah. I think I just have to be a little bit closer.
So you gotta be really accurate.
Yeah.
Like, we know what to do, but it's just the execution. And this is the kind of game where you don't want the execution to be too difficult. Whoops.
Yeah, I feel like if you know what to do, the execution shouldn't be holding you back, you know?
Right.
But I don't know. I'm not here to critique this this indie game.
You're not? I am.
Oh.
Well, I mean, that's kind of what we did here.
Yeah. I mean, okay, so I am here to critique this indie game, but you know what I mean? Like, this game has plenty of other merits. I'm not gonna harp on it too much.
Yeah, we'll definitely harp.
I'm gonna harp the correct amount, whatever is necessary. Wait.
Yeah, we'll say what we like about it and what we don't. So you gotta like slide real quick?
Yeah.
There you go. That'll work.
Hey, look, we got out, I think. Yeah. Oh, we did it. I think that was the first level. That whole thing. Oh, no. Squiggly wire.
Is this another different beast? Or is this the same beast?
It's probably the same one, right?
I think it's a different beast.
Oh, I'm faster now. Take that.
Oh, this guy is really good at basketball.
I know.
This game should be called NBA 2K2.
This game should just be called Look at Me Throw. Oh, no.
Oh, he blocked your shot.
Come here. Look at me walk into
At least he can't take a shot. All he seems to be able to do is block shots.
Or if that's just timing. Yeah, he doesn't really seem to be interested. He's not interested in playing the game. He just wants to block you from playing. What?
Was that multiple copies of yourself?
Yeah. Why? I don't know. What? tickle. He's tickling me. Tickle me, ammo. What?
Maybe that ball will slowly roll back to you?
No.
I think this might be a glitch.
I think it's a glitch.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Huh.
We got a glitch on our hands.
Why? Yeah, that's me standing there. That's me in the corner.
So either it's a really cool effect where there's like a time thing where you can where you have to shoot multiple times as multiples of yourself, or that's a glitch and the basketball going really slowly back to you is a glitch. All right, let's see what happens. Yeah, it was definitely a glitch.
Yeah, that can't be intended behavior.
I think that's all right. That was definitely on purpose.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, so that's 3 points, but...
Where's the ball?
It's over there.
You can just run through.
Didn't I try that before?
Yeah, I think you did. I think just now you're allowed to walk through.
All right.
I don't think you were allowed before.
That was kind of weird. So, okay, I'm not really sure what the challenge is right now. What if you just run past him? Okay.
You probably have to run back, go back and forth, so that you gain some momentum, so that you can stretch it out more. Maybe not. It does seem to stop you at the exact same spot every time now.
I wonder if I have to throw it from, like, right before, like, right there.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, but he blocked you from up top there.
Oh, wait.
Oh, it's blocked. There's, like, an exact spot, probably, you gotta do it.
Huh?
Hmm.
What?
Try running back and then do it at the peak of this. Right there. That didn't work.
Oh, let's try it again. Let's try it again.
Maybe run back and forth twice so you get a lot of momentum.
I don't think it's momentum, though. I don't think momentum has anything to do with it.
Yeah, I think we discovered that earlier. You're right.
I think you just have to throw it over...
Over top of everything?
Yeah.
And then maybe, yeah. You may be right. Hmm.
Come on, you monster!
Looks pretty clunky.
It's kind of clunky. It's kind of clunky, but hey, this is an experience I've never had before in a game. So, based on experience alone, I like it. I guess we can fake him out.
Yeah, maybe that's what this is, to fake him out. But that one tentacle, the one that's really blocking you, never seems to give up.
Yeah.
Yeah, video games are pretty cool. Pretty fun.
Fake out! Can I shoot it from back here?
I think so.
I wonder if that's what you have to do. You just have to time it.
That's gotta go in, because...
Yeah!
But it went through the thing that was blocking you before.
Yeah, it kind of did.
I don't really understand. I don't understand how you solved that, but you solved it.
Wait, is this the same... Oh, okay, so you can't just... Okay, so it looks like you have to go back here again. Huh? So now we're being blocked by a bunch of these things. Eh?
Hmm. I don't understand.
I'm not sure that I do. I think you just throw it right in the middle here, maybe? No.
Sorry, I'm getting notes.
That's cool.
I'm not trying to be rude.
Oh, come on! Just get it in there!
Oh, come on.
Like, if this is a puzzle, it doesn't present itself as a puzzle, you know?
Yeah, maybe do it back from the left side, because every other shot has gone in from far to the left. The far left would like you to believe.
The far left. Yeah, but I can't get past this first tentacle here. So it has to be somewhere after that, and it can't
be
right there.
Would it be, like, right in between these two? Well, you've tried that before,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Hmm. Yeah, it's a little esoteric, then.
Right there. Yeah, it's a little,
We like that word today.
Yeah, we do like that word. I like that word all the time, actually. Like, is there something I'm missing? Do I need to fake him out? Hmm. I don't know. We can call it here if you want. You want to keep going?
I want to see what happens in the story and see what happens next, but I don't really know what to do here.
Yeah, I don't want to don't know. I don't want to waste people's time and make them watch me play this over and over. I feel like this, at least this is enough time to sort of get a feel for the game, you know? Let's see. So that one, the one to the right, doesn't go down.
It won't go down.
Well then, how in the world... Oh...
Do you understand it? Did you figure it out?
Well, so that tentacle... I wonder if that tentacle can shoot the ball up.
Oh, maybe. Yeah, maybe that you have to time it so that it...
Does that make sense?
It, I don't know. That seems like a long shot. I'm pretty sure that's just... If that's the answer, that's a pretty dumb answer.
Well...
Like, when you start trying all the really awkward things that nobody would think of...
Yeah, I think
it's that's usually not the answer in a game, and if it is, you just stop playing the game, because if it's going to give you a stupid answer, like, if the answer to a puzzle is something stupid, like, you have to shoot it right when that thing is going up...
Yeah, that's a good point.
Then... It's got to be something else. But what's the answer? What's the idea here? We can't figure it out. We're like, two men.
I don't even know what the concept that we're supposed to be, you know, like, we're supposed to be being tested on something right now.
Yeah, we're two men who've played a lot of video games, but we haven't played a lot of basketball. Maybe it's something to do with basketball that we're not thinking of.
Like shooting balls at hoops? I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. It's probably not. We put... He had a slam dunk.
What?
What the fuck?
Why did that work that time and not
I don't know.
The other times?
The tentacle let a little bit loose. You got a little slack there. I don't know. I don't know, man.
I love the visual style.
And now there's a bird grabbing the...
We're going to do some bee battle with this bird.
Maybe do some bee battle in the air. Oh, is Dad dead?
Hey, Dad. No, I'm just a ghost. This is just a family ghost.
No, but you'll be home late. It's not like I can go on now. Why not? I can't fly, not like you.
Oh.
Sure you can, smiley face.
Emoji.
How? I never could. You always could. I can't read that fast. Keep jumping. Hold X.
All right.
Oh, pretty awesome. You get a double jump now.
That looks like an infinite jump, though.
That's my boy. That's more than a double jump.
What is this game?
So Dad gave you the ability to fly.
Yeah. Oh, you're right. It is a double jump. I think. Wait, no, it's not. It's something. It's something that I don't know what it is.
This is pretty cool.
It is pretty cool.
I think this game's too challenging for the type of game that it is.
No, I'm not even pressing anything.
But this part doesn't seem too challenging.
Nah.
But the part we just did...
Well, I think it was just unclear.
Yeah,
you know,
it was
like,
just unclear.
Yeah. It wasn't challenging in the sense that, like, Wings of V... I always go to that game. In the sense that Wings of V is challenging. It's just challenging in the way that you don't know what the limits of the game mechanics are. You don't really know what you're expected to do. Wait, are we... racing this dude?
I think we're trying to catch up to him to get that basketball back, because this is our precious basketball that was given to us by our father.
I hate asking the question, is this what we're supposed to be doing? Because if you don't even know what your goal is, you're going to have a real tough time achieving it.
Yeah.
Like, is this an endlessly scrolling landscape here? It kind of looks like it.
I think it is.
That raises the question about the clouds. The clouds slow you down? Are they randomly placed? Is this just one repeating background? What are my options here?
I think you just gotta get that basketball.
Oh, I'm doing what I can. Okay, so...
That was undodgeable.
That's also undodgeable.
I think maybe when you start catching up, it starts hurling this at you. So there's a basketball net there.
Why?
Not really sure.
What?
You went through... Oh, when you go through those nets, they speed you up.
Oh.
That's what those are. Those are speed boosts. Those are like turbo boosts in a kart racing game.
All right. Now I get it, but oof. If you hadn't said that, I wouldn't have known.
I just realized that.
And where are they now? Where are they?
Yeah, you could really use some of those right now. They're too far behind.
Yeah, I wonder if they only show up when you're close. I wonder if this is procedurally generated, you know?
You're probably just at this part. It might not be procedurally generated. It must just be repeating, like a repeating background. And then once you get to a certain point, it shows you it just keeps putting those walls of clouds.
Yeah.
And then once you get a certain point closer to the bird, it probably shows you the speed boost ones. And that's probably the end where you're going to catch up.
This is really story driven. This is very heavily story driven. So it looks like you've really got to invest in the story here. Did I do it?
You didn't get him. I think you got to get one more of those. Wow, the bird speeds up. But now we're at lightning, so you must have crossed some threshold or some point there where.
I guess doing it twice. That rain is kind of distracting though.
Yeah, I don't really like it.
That's
it looks like static. Yeah, it's I think a there's bit just too many much. Raindrops.
Either that or it's combined with the there's sort of like a film grain effect on the game.
Yeah, there is a film grain.
Yeah,
I think we're recording at 30 frames a second too. So those lightning bolts slow you down.
All right. So not only do you have to race to get this basketball, but you have to stop for these lightning branches
or just somehow dodge them.
Well,
it looks frustrating.
I don't know.
It looks frustrating and difficult.
Yeah. I mean, a game like this is not about 100% precise controls, so dodging them is not always the easiest thing.
Right.
So, which is kind of problematic.
Right. So I think just make it easy. I think make the game easier. I don't think anyone would complain if this game was very, very easy.
Yeah, and anything like this, it looks like it's story-driven, needs to be very, very easy.
Yeah, this is an interactive story more than a... Like, if I'm going to play a hardcore platformer, there's infinite games that are better. There's thousands of games that are better than this. So this game doesn't need to be an awesome, difficult platformer.
Yeah.
There's plenty of those. This is a game where we want to see what happens next.
Like, I'm already...
Just experience the game.
I'm already intrigued by the story. I already want to know what's happening here, but... I have to...
What? We got it. You got 7 points.
Yeah. But you have to slog through a semi-tedious... I don't know what that is. That section. All right.
Does this game take place in Paris? I just saw the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah. But they speak English. All right. So we just looked this game up on YouTube. Turns out it's 43 minutes long.
For how long to beat, right?
Well, we looked it up on YouTube and also how long to beat. Oh, what? Whoa.
So we're going to see if we can just finish it.
Yeah. Because just now I was thinking... If it's sort of a long game, maybe a couple hours, we weren't going to play through the whole thing.
Yeah.
Oh.
No, it'll still probably be in our wild game series, but we usually don't finish games in that.
Oh! What?
Don't know what to do here. You probably got to I guess it's a slide. Maybe you got to run and slide and time it or something?
I'm going to fake out. No? What? Hello? Hello?
Yeah, you gotta fake him out before he'll do the... Before he'll jump, though.
Oh.
Maybe you gotta hit it, and then he'll jump?
Yeah,
you gotta hit it first.
Okay.
Okay, I think maybe back up?
Ah. Okay.
This might be a perfect timing thing. I think maybe... Okay, shoot it from far back, and then...
Yeah, you're right.
Run and...
Ow.
But you gotta hit it on that, like, that light purple part.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure.
I did not hit it.
Yeah, so you maybe get a little closer.
Let's try it from, like, here. Nope. Let's try it from a little bit further back, but... Did that do it? Oh yeah, you can fly.
Oh yeah.
I forgot.
So we can need the ball.
Oh yeah. So you can only fly when you're not carrying a ball.
Oh really?
I guess. So really, flying does nothing. Except, see ya. I'm out of here. Alright, let's see here. So let's try this again. Yeah,
You can't fly, right?
You're right.
See, you gotta slide on that.
Okay, let's try it again.
Oh, you did it right.
That was it. Yeah. I just had to run a little bit more before I was sliding. All right. One point
out of what? How many? I don't know. Last time it was only 7, but I think it was supposed to be 11 some of the times. I don't know. It's an arbitrary number.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like it.
Or we're just not paying attention. It's
one of the two. Oh.
Okay. So we understand how to do this now. That you gotta hit that purple, that lighter purple.
Yeah. All right. I have a problem with this. You want to guess what it is? Because you probably will have the same problem.
You don't know where to shoot it from?
Yeah, you have no idea where to shoot it from.
It's just guessing. It's not really particularly fun.
Unless
it doesn't really feel rewarding, I guess.
Yeah, unless the ball's height is automatic. No, it's not, because it worked that time. Yeah, it feels completely arbitrary. So it's just trial and error. And if you really bent on breaking the flow of your game, that's one good way to do it. You know? Alright, so let's see here. Oh, hello.
I mean, a lot of games are trial and error, but you want to feel like it's actually there's a different way to do it.
Yes,
yeah. I'm not being very.
You should learn from trial and error. You know, that's what trial and error is all about. About getting more information from what's happening. You know.
So that's not his sister.
For you, let's go.
I'm not Belle.
Oh. This is my family.
So she's in a family with a bunch of purple creatures?
I guess.
These creatures aren't family. Let's go home.
Let's go home. I am home.
You know how long it's been? Long enough for you to hurt my family. I had to get through them to get to you.
I had to school them at b-ball.
So you have to beat her at basketball now?
I guess. It's okay. Nice try.
She's pretty short.
She is.
Oh no, she took the ball from you. You're going to lose to your little sister at basketball. Do you know how embarrassing that is? I've never lost at basketball to my little sister. Have you ever played basketball with my little sister?
No.
I don't think so.
No. Did you see? She was surprised just now that we could fly.
She was?
Yeah.
That's a pretty cool touch.
You know what?
I wasn't looking at the screen for a second.
Who cares about who wins the game? I can fly. She can't.
Yeah, I know. You know just what I mean? Fly away.
Come on, man. Priorities. What's cooler, being able to fly or win a game of basketball? Because the answer is fly. Okay, so you can't win here, I'm pretty sure. She runs faster than you, for one thing.
And yeah, there's like no way to block that.
She's doing
some of these NBA Jam style moves. And then she does the undershot like she did when she was a little kid. It's a little callback. Oh, you could have got the ball there.
Are you sure? Oh, you're right.
Yeah, you could have snagged it right there.
Am I actually going to lose?
And now she stinks it at basketball. She went from being really good to really stinking.
Yeah.
I think she's stinking.
She just let me win.
Yeah, it seems that way. Or maybe she's just out of steam.
Oh.
No, she pushed you over. That's a foul.
This game doesn't really seem to have any fail state. I think...
I don't want the bag. Just you.
I wonder if that was scripted. Like, she's guaranteed to get 4 in a row, and the next one you're going to score. Like,
she doesn't belong here when she got the bag that her dad gave.
Wait, really? That's it? That's what... Not your brother, like, telling you all these things about, you know, your life? It was the bag?
So are you flying now?
Yeah, I guess I'm flying now. What is that?
Rings. Oh, the rings are good.
Oh, rings are good.
The rings send you flying.
Dude, what if we're the basketball? What if life is a basketball? Wait, what?
I don't know if the game's that deep.
What if it is?
To convince you that... If there was a game that could convince you that
your
life was an actual rubber ball filled with air...
What if?
Well, I would question your sanity, or I would really commend the developer of the game for managing the brainwashing technique.
But dude,
so effective.
Dude, for real. Think about it. Oh, I get it. Okay, so this makes sense.
Does it tell you where they're at?
Yeah, based on where it is on the screen when it comes up the first time. Mm. So, like, see, that's not... Oh, well, that's different, actually. That's a different pattern. But see, that one's on the right side, so it's going to fall on the right. Those two are on the left, they're going to fall on the left.
This is good. So, this is good design here.
This is for sure. So now we just gotta wait for Hoop to show up. This reminds me of that curtain game in Mario RPG when you're in Booster's Tower, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Because you just have to choose the right side.
Super Mario RPG, the first game we ever played on GameSoup.
Yeah, it was. We had some serious problems with it, though.
Okay, this is actually pretty cool.
Yeah, this is...
This is probably my favorite part of the game so far.
This is pretty cool. It's pretty simple, again, mechanically, but... Oh.
Oh, shit.
I mean, I'm curious if you actually lose progress... I feel like
you might have to do this a little bit longer, probably.
Yeah, I don't think this isn't a game you can lose.
Yeah, this doesn't seem too hard either.
Nah.
Like, at least it's controllable and you feel like it was... It looks like, at least. You're the one playing, but it looks like you kind of feel like it was your fault if you get hit here. A little more than the other parts.
I'm kind of just a moron, too. I'm not... I don't know. Oh.
I don't know, you've played thousands of video games, so you probably...
Thousands, you think?
I'm just guessing. Maybe I'm projecting. I have.
Well, I've played at least six. I know that much. I know I've played at least six, maybe eight. I don't know. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, that is really cool. Oh, 360, 720, slam dunk.
That looked really cool.
That was a 1080 slam dunk.
That looked like a lot of fun.
I'm patenting that move. Well, yeah, it was pretty fun.
It looked like it was... I don't think you're going to be able to get the ball going this way, though. I think you got to go the other direction.
Yeah, I think you're right. It does look cool.
Counterclockwise. Oh, he switched around though. So now you're going to go back the way you were going, I think, to get
it. I wonder if you just have to jump over that bump every time.
I think that's what that bump is there for, yeah.
Yeah, that's
to
okay.
be an obstacle. Obstinate.
So it does look cool, but in reality, all I'm doing is holding right on the All I'm doing is holding right on the arrows, right, the arrow key, and pressing X to jump. So like mechanically, it's not hard at all.
Yeah.
It just looks kind of cool.
Like a Sonic the Hedgehog kind
of. Yeah, exactly.
Pretty much Sonic is full of these loop-de-loop things, and it makes you look like you're really good at a game or really awesome, but
Sonic,
in reality...
Sonic didn't have these barriers such as your sister, like, stopping you. Well, the newer Sonic games did because they were crap, right?
Yeah.
But like, that bump that's
on
the floor
slows
you down.
They tried to slow those games down as much as possible. Every Sonic game that's come out since 2000.
Yeah. All right, so this is just a sequence of ducking and jumping, which is fine, but they're kind of frustrating to hit. I guess the answer is for me just to get good. Like, I shouldn't fault a game if I'm not good at it. I should just say, hey, get good. Get good. Alright, I'm gonna get good.
There.
I'm gonna get good.
You got it, man.
Come here, get good. Yeah, I got good.
You got 7 points.
Seven. Out of
how many? You really angered the purple demon. I wonder if this is a metaphor for something.
No, I don't think so.
This is not the most obvious...
I think this is just something to be taken very literally.
It's very obvious that it is a metaphor.
I don't think there's any hidden meaning behind anything.
No.
Do you think?
This is actually meant to be taken as a literal story. This actually happened. This is an autobiography.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I thought this was based on a true story.
So now you're doing the opposite. You're flying down. Now you got points
that's,
for that.
Oh, because
you went through the hoop. You went through the hoop with the basketball, so you got a point for that.
Yeah.
Did you see that? That's pretty cool.
Yeah,
that's
I get
pretty
it.
Pretty neat addition.
Hey... Lamau. Alright, okay, there we go. Slam. Come on and slam. Come on and slam. Come on and slam. That's all I gotta say about that. Come on and slam. Aw. I like that. I like that animation. Well, the lack of animation. Just that still image. Where are these hoops at? Yeah. Get these points.
You got 10. You gotta get 11.
Oh, well, then we're almost there.
11's the magic number.
Why is 11 the magic number? Is that a metaphor for, like...
I think that's how many points you have to get in one-on-one basketball to win.
Really?
I think so, yeah.
That's
You can tell we're real big basketball fans.
That's an actual real-life rule, then?
I think so.
Oh. That's not how I play one-on-one basketball.
I don't know, maybe not.
Usually the person that I'm playing beats me with a score of 11-0 and I sit in the corner crying.
I thought you were going to say beats you with a crowbar or something.
Oh, that too. It's over.
I've been practicing all day. Yeah,
I'm hungry. I think you've earned dinner.
He doesn't give him dinner usually. What a terrible father.
My children, you may only eat if you surpass.
Are you going to burn it again like last time? I set the timer this time, so it should be fine. So is this like a single dad here?
I guess.
Maybe.
I guess I can move here. God, he's such a sadistic man. He only feeds his children if they get better at basketball every day.
Your mother would be proud.
Made with love and cardboard.
Yeah. Was it made with actual cardboard?
Well, it sure looks like it.
Yeah.
What if this was just a cardboard cutout adventure? It wasn't even a PC game? The mountains.
They just send you a bunch of cardboard cutouts of these characters. They're like, hey, make up the story.
They send you the soundtrack on a cassette tape. And they send you these cardboard cutouts.
And you have to bounce a basketball to make the base.
Oh.
So it was a story of a family. And... I'm guessing that, like, the daughter maybe fell away from the family in the story.
Yeah.
She was, like, maybe got in with a bad crowd, which was represented by the purple monsters, and the older brother talked some sense into her, and she came back.
By shooting some hoops.
Yeah.
If there's one thing this man can do, it's he knows how to shoot hoops.
That's my guess what it is, but I'm not a literary expert. I've read very few books.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Yeah. Well, it's good to see games that are... I mean, this is clearly a very story-driven game. It's interesting to see how gameplay can tie in with that in a unique way. I've never seen a game that focused on basketball like this. So this is a brand new experience. And if I've only played 8 games, then this will be number 9. So
I think you'd be happy with that.
Yeah. Yeah, I was pretty happy with that. I mean, you know, mechanical quirks aside, you play this game for the story.
Yeah. There were a few hiccups, and we definitely were quite vocal about them. But
also, the game is 43 minutes long. So
yeah, it's a short game.
You're looking for the experience.
I'm not going to ask for my money back for this one, for sure. Like, we played another game for about 40 minutes on GameSoup. It was Curse of the Crescent Isle.
Yeah, that was bad because it was mechanically flawed in a game that focused on game mechanics.
It was mechanically flawed and loaded with bugs.
That too. Yeah, that too.
That one I would be justified to get my money back for. But this one, you know what? I think I got what I was looking for out of the game, and you seem to like it.
Yeah, this was really cool. I want to go back sometime and play this, especially now that I know what what the flow of the story is. It's very short. It's concise. I'm gonna go back at some point and just, you know, try to dig a little bit deeper into it. You know, because even though I'm pretty sure there were no metaphors at all, everything is very literal. I want to go back and see if I can maybe extract some meaning out of it. You know,
so if you guys want to do the same, it's on Steam. So pick it up.
Yeah, it's on sale for what did you say, $1.50?
I don't remember. It was pretty cheap.
It's basically free. Just go pick it up.
All right.
Well, I guess that's it then. Thanks for watching, GameSuit. We'll see you guys next time.
Give us a thumbs down.